Hey guys, in this tutorial, I want to be showing you how to use the new updated version of the Logo Package Express. So I've been using it for over a year now, and it's been super great. And I've been using it on every logo design project I have. And you can see here's the website. You can check them out, what they do. And I also include a link in the description below, so definitely check that out. And you can see sort of how it works here. And my friend, Michael, he's a great designer, and he created this, which is really good to save time. So I'm going to jump into Illustrator here, and I've got this client logo that I have to package up, right? So what I like to do is you have to install the extension, and once you have the extension, you can see that you can go over here and open it in the extensions panel, and I'm going to open that up right now. And then I've got my logo window here. So I'm going to select my logo that I have, and then I'm going to click set logo. So you can see a box will pop up that says convert close black to blacks. It will say some very dark colors have been detected. Do you want them to be converted to true black? And because they're an off black, they're not actually like 100% black. I'm going to click no because I selected a custom dark color for that. So you can see what we have here is you've got logo, the logo mark, logo type, and the tagline as well, which is really cool. We can also actually change some of the settings. So I can click on the little cog in the corner. And you can see the new updated tabs here. So they've included all these new functions. So you got the formats, so print and web, because it's not gonna, I don't really need the print files. All I need is a PNG. Also the AI, I can save that by itself. And if they need it for the website, then I can include SVG as well. But I'm just gonna include PNG for now. I can also go to naming. I can also change the presets to dashes, underscores, or spaces, depending how I want it. You can also see part of the file extension name, which is here. So I like this section because we have control over how the presets work. I can have capitalization. I can also have the folder naming as well, not only the file naming. So I think that is super amazing. And then we can change the default names to whatever you like. So maybe your client is not tech savvy. You can actually change all the names of each individual folder, which is really cool. If we go to the third scale, you can hear we can choose scale presets. So we can actually enter a preset and save a preset here. So after you change this, it's gonna save. And with the web scales, you can see you got pixels, as you can see here, and then you've got the PPI. Obviously, most screens are under 150 PPI, so unless it's like a retina display from Mac, but typically, what I like to do with the scales is I just like to do a typical 1080 is fine. I don't know why I'd add a text in the back there. But usually a low res would be between 500 and 1000. And then beyond that is like going beyond like 2000 pixels, which is fine. And typically I will like customize it. Sometimes I do like 800, which is fine. And then I can add a different scale as well. So I can also add a version where it's like 4000 pixels. I'm going to bump up the PPI as well like this. So you can see here, this looks like the max width for the pixel, which is fine. So I'm gonna have a low res and sort of a high res version. I'm gonna also go to padding now. And typically this is what you add when you add some clear space around the logo. So right now you can see, if I zoom into the actual logo, you can see there's no space on the edges. And sometimes Illustrator actually cuts off a bit of the shape. So it's also good to have some pixels. Typically I like having around, 20 pixels is fine. So you can see, got a little bit of space there, which is good. And whatever space you set, then that's the space you should set for your logo design. And then you can see you can have different on the width if I want. If you don't want it linked, you can like break it and I can go 40 and 40. So maybe you want it more wider. It's up to you, but you can also link it and just press 20 and whatever you do. I think that's fine. You can also change it as well here. And then lastly, we've got color. If you're using Pantones, you can use these. I don't really need that, so I can turn those off. The inversion, this sort of shows you what's gonna happen between the light and the dark colors. So if it's gonna change it to white, typically I just leave it to on 50, which is fine, and leave it automatic, and it does a good job by itself. So once you're happy with all those options, we can always click back, and then I'm gonna go back, and I'm just gonna delete that text there. And then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna select my icon here, and then click logo mark. I'm going to select the logo type here and then go set logo type. and then I'll select the tagline and then click set tagline. So now we've got the full logo, the mark by itself, the logo type, and the tagline. Then once I'm happy with that, I can click make web logos. So now it'll start to generate all those logos automatically, literally in like 10 seconds. And you can see we've got all these logos and they are looking super cool. You can see here on these logos here that it's not inverting it. So I'm probably gonna have to go back and fix this logo and make sure that the shape is like punched out of there in the shape, which is totally fine. And if I don't actually want any of these, what you can actually do, so for example, maybe I don't want these ones down here. I can select all these and literally just delete that. So I can delete that. If I don't want the grayscale, I can delete those. And it's not going to save any of those colors. So I've got the full color one, I've got the one color, and then the reverse, as you can see all there, which is beautiful. Once you're happy with that, we can click export. And then I'm going to type in the client name. We can type logo package. I'm going to browse. And I usually save it in my client folder. And hopefully I can find it. 2020. Doo-doo-doo. And then I can make a new folder here. Call it delivery. And then I'm going to press O. Okay. So now you can see it's going to save in this folder. Once you're happy, we can press create. And it should start to export all of those files. And because I only selected PNG, it will just save the transparent PNGs in those sizes that we set. And now you can see it's doing its thing. It's loading it all within that folder. And I love this plugin, it's so worth it. You know, it's a one-time fee, it's not a subscription, so you can really have it for ages. And you can use it for every logo project, because back in the day, people used to constantly, you know, make it manually and it would take too long. So once it's done, I can jump in here, and then you got the full color, the one color, and the reverse, and you can see it didn't add the grayscale or the inversion because I deleted that. I can double click into here, then you can see we've got that logo there, which is awesome. So that is the logo. We've got the logo mark, which is like the icon by itself, as you can see there. And then we've got the logo with the tagline, which is like the full main logo, which is beautiful. Find your voice. I think that is super amazing. And then we've got the other ones here, obviously the logo type by itself, as you can see there. So as you can see, it's such a great extension and it works every time with powerful logos. And if I did the print versions, when I double click on the folder, you can see how it just has digital. There'll be another print version there. So hopefully you guys like this extension, Logo Package Express 2.0. Definitely check it out, it's worth the money. And you know, once you finish, you can just click finish. If you'd like to begin, you can click no there, and it's gonna be super, super cool. You can also click on the information button as well, just before I exit. You can see there's a quick tutorial here, but obviously I'm showing you in this tutorial how to use it. You've got more tutorials, it'll take you to a YouTube page. So Michael has done short tutorials there if you get stuck. You've got some FAQs as well. And then a cool thing about this is you can actually become an affiliate as well, just like I am. So overall, it's a great extension. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for watching this video. And let me know in the comments if you like seeing these type of videos. Remember to smash the like button and subscribe for more design content every week. Talk to you soon. Have an awesome night.